Welcome to MooMooMath and Science. In this video, I'd like to talk about active transport in a cell. In order to stay alive, cells need to move objects into and out of them. There are two types of cell transport: passive transport, which does not require energy, and active transport, which requires energy. Think of passive transport as riding a bike down a hill, and active transport riding the same bike up the hill, which requires a lot more energy. Let's see why active transport requires energy. Sometimes the cell needs to move objects from a low concentration to a high concentration or up the concentration gradient. Or an object may be too large to pass through a membrane. In these instances, active transport is used, and this requires energy. The energy for active transport is supplied by the energy molecule ATP, adenosine triphosphate. In this video, I will discuss three types of active transport: membrane pumps, endocytosis, and exocytosis. A membrane pump, such as a sodium-potassium pump, moves substances up the concentration gradient, or from a low concentration to a high concentration. A sodium-potassium pump moves 3 sodium ions for every 2 potassium ions into the cell and uses ATP as energy. The channel changes its shape and allows the sodium and potassium to move into and out of the cell. The cell also uses two types of vesicle movement called endocytosis and exocytosis. Endocytosis allows the cell to move larger objects into the cell by engulfing the object and moving the object into the cell. During exocytosis, the cell expels an object out of the cell. For example, this neuron is using a vesicle to expel the neurotransmitters that are enclosed in a vesicle. There we go, active transport. Energy is required to move objects into and out of it. Thanks for watching, and MooMooMath uploads a new math and science video every day. Please subscribe and share.